What's up guys, it's Salvajee from the Salvajee Cartel. In this video I want to share with you guys some Trials of Osiris tips. I actually used these tips, and when I was using these tips I actually won 2 matches in Trials of Osiris with my whole team using No Land Beyonds only, alright? So definitely watch this video. I'm gonna be sharing with you guys some really cool tips. I mean, I find these tips helpful and I see a lot of players committing this mistake. So anyways, let's get started. Okay, so this really isn't a tip, but the first thing you wanna do is you wanna make sure your team is all right, you know? I don't recommend playing Trials of Osiris with randoms because mainly, you know, you could get like a random that just freaks out and starts screaming. You could get a random that's nice but sucks. Or you get a random that just really, really sucks, and then you don't want to kick him out because, you know, you are already like 3 games in and, you know, you guys are kind of winning, but you know, like you're only carrying him. So I recommend that you guys play with your friends. If you don't have any friends, of course, go on Destiny LG and, you know, look for people there. But yeah, have a good team. That's like the first thing, number one. Obviously, that's the obvious one. So yeah, let's get started with the actual tips. So the first thing that you guys want to do is you want to go into Trials of Osiris with a good setup, alright? You guys want to be using a setup that you're comfortable with, but also a setup that's good. For example, don't run a No Land Beyond on Trials, unless you're like my Trials team that we ran 3 No Land Beyonds, you know, all 3 of us, and yeah, we actually won 2 matches using No Land Beyonds. But yeah, if you're going through Trials to win, I recommend these following weapons. The Vex Mythal Clasp, Thorn, Last Word, Hawk Moon. Another hand cannon that you could use, because you know, we all know hand cannons are really, really good. You can use the Red Hand 9, it's from New Monarchy. Also the hand cannon Her Mercy would be really, really good as well. You mainly want to stick with hand cannons, in my opinion. I mean, at least that's what I use all the time. And pulse rifles, since pulse rifles are pretty, pretty good. But like I said, your primary, it's all about you. If you're comfortable using a bad juju, use the bad juju. You need to use weapons that you're comfortable with and you have fun using. Okay, now for the real deal. You guys want to be running these things that I like to call combo strategies. Maybe there's another name for it, but I call them combo strategies. What I mean by this is my friend Soul runs a flashbang, I run a firebolt grenade, and my friend Angels, let's say he runs 2 firebolt grenades, right? For example, my friend Soul throws a flashbang, and then Angels throws 2 firebolt grenades to finish off the enemies. You guys want to have those sort of quote-unquote combos. For example, I'm gonna shoot 2 bullets of the Thorn into my dude, and then you're going to throw your flux grenade, and yeah, no, not the flux grenade, your arc bolt grenade, and then you're going to finish them off with the arc bolt grenade. You guys want to have a strategy. You guys don't simply want to go into Trials pretty much just hoping that you're going to win because you saw some YouTube video. Also, one more thing, the heavy round. You don't want to be using a legendary. If you have the truth, I recommend you switch to an okay primary that you like using that's legendary, for example, a hand cannon, whatever you guys like. And yeah, take out your truth and use the truth. And here's the reason why you should use the truth on Trials, and I really haven't seen any YouTubers sort of mention this, at least the ones that I watch. First of all, truth has aggressive tracking. Second of all, it has 3 bullets in the magazine, or whatever the rocket thing is called. And also, truth has grenades and horseshoes, which means that you don't really have to throw the rocket too close to the person. As long as you hit them, or as long as it's close to them, you will get the kill. And as you guys can see, like right there, I got completely obliterated. But yeah, other than that, I recommend rockets like the Ash Factory, Radagast Fury, Dream Waker. Any rocket with tripod and grenades and horseshoes is really, really good. Like I said, throughout this week, I'm going to be posting some of my trial setup, you know, so you guys can like copy it and, you know, hopefully get some wins out there. One of the main reasons why a person loses a trials match and why I actually didn't go flawless this week, it's because, yeah, you start winning a lot of matches and then you start rushing in into the enemy spawn, and that's exactly where you guys get killed. Sometimes it is smart to actually hold back. Oh, and by the way, what you guys are about to see right here is actually one of my combo strategies. I throw my firebolt and I tell Soul to finish off this player. Bam, there you go. And talking about finishing off enemies, what you guys mainly want to do at least 90% of the time, you guys want to have 2 people rush in from one side and 1 person trying to flank them. And if that's not working out, all 3 of you guys go together. When you take out the first enemy, send 1 of the people in there rushing, Because you don't want the enemy team to get a revive. When the enemy team gets a revive, that means that you literally have to start the whole kind of show all over again. You have to get that kill, then you have to like play strategically. Sometimes playing strategically is nice, but sometimes you have to rush in there, because when there's one enemy against, when there's two enemies against three enemies, chances are that you are going to get another kill and you will be able to get the revive as soon as possible. Now, of course, these tips are not going to make you win all the time. You know, sometimes things do happen where you are just going against a team that's really, really good. And yeah, guys, my last and final tip is just chill. You know, don't take trials so seriously. You know, I know everybody wants to get those 8 wins. I know everybody wants to go flawless, but just look at it this way. You're going to have pretty much the entire year to go flawless. You know, throughout the whole course of you playing Destiny, you have all of that time to go flawless. So don't get stressed with Trials of Osiris, guys. Go out there and have some fun. Use a Noland Beyond in Trials. And yeah, I'll be uploading my Noland Beyond in Trials victory pretty soon. Hope you guys enjoyed the video.